Well, good evening and welcome to our Lenten devotional service here at St. John's Lutheran Church in Williamstown, New Jersey. I am Pastor Tammy Harmer, and I'm joined here with some members of our ministry team. We have Deacon Ken Weaver and Deacon Betsy Ely, our organist, Janice Smith. Audio video, we have Henry Fickenshire, and on clarinet this evening, Bill Mason. And we're just delighted to have you worship with us this evening. I'd like to begin with a reading from the book of Job in chapter 14. If mortals die, will they live again? All the days of my service, I would wait until my release should come. If you would call and I would answer you, you would long for the work of your hands. For then you would not number my steps, you would not keep watch over my sin. My transgression would be sealed up in a bag, and you would cover over my iniquity. But the mountain falls and crumbles away, and the rock is removed from its place. The waters wear away the stones, the torrents wash away the soil of the earth. So you destroy the hope of mortals. You prevail forever against them, and they pass away. You change their countenance and send them away. Their children come to honor, and they do not know it. They are brought low, then it goes unnoticed. They feel only the pain of their own bodies and mourn only for themselves. Let us pray now. Luther's evening prayer. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We thank you, our Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have graciously kept us this day. And we pray that you would forgive us all our sins where we have done wrong, and graciously keep us this night. For into your hands we commend ourselves, our body, our soul, and all things. Let your holy angel be with us, that the evil foe may have no power over us. Amen.
A reading from Psalm 115, 1 through 13. Not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to your name give glory, for the sake of your steadfast love and your faithfulness. Why should the nations say, "Where is their God?" Our God is in the heavens. He does whatever he pleases. Their idols are silver and gold, the work of human hands. They have mouths, but do not speak, eyes, but do not see. They have ears, but do not hear, noses, but do not smell. They have hands, but do not feel, feet, but do not walk. They make no sound in their throats. Those who make them are like them. So are all who trust in them. O Israel, trust in the Lord. He is their help and their shield. O house of Aaron, trust in the Lord. He is their help and their shield. You who fear the Lord, trust in the Lord. He is their help and their shield. The Lord has been mindful of us. He will bless us. He will bless the house of Israel. He will bless the house of Aaron. He will bless those who fear the Lord, both small and great.
Amen. A gathering hymn this evening is There Is a Balm in Gilead. It's in the ELW, page number 614. It's an African-American spiritual with roots in the Hebrew scripture, with Gilead being the name of the mountainous region east of the Jordan River. It was a region known for skillful physicians and medicines made from the gum of a particular tree in that area. Many believed that this ointment or balm had miraculous powers to heal the body. God warns the people of Israel in the book of Jeremiah, that the healing power of the balm does not give spiritual healing as a relief for their oppression, reminding them that God is always in control and is the only one who can truly relieve their suffering. We know that God answers the suffering spirits of God's people by sending Jesus, who becomes our balm of Gilead, who can empathize with our hurts, can feel what we feel, who we can turn to in times of trial. We sing this song, "There is a balm in Gilead," as Christians understanding that Jesus loves us. He loves us so much that he takes our suffering upon himself for our salvation.
Season of Lent, when we look upon the crucifix, our hearts can feel a deep sense of shame, affected by the suffering servant we see there who carried our sinfulness to the cross. A medieval passion poem evokes those feelings through the words written as if Christ was speaking directly to us, and I will read that for you. Man and woman, look on me. How much I suffered for you, see? Look on my back laid bare with whips. Look on my side from which blood drips. My feet and hands are nailed upon the rood. From pricking thorns, my temples run with blood. From side to side, from head to foot, turn and turn my body about. You there shall find all over blood. 5 wounds I suffered for you, see? So turn your heart to me.
Be comforted with the words of Octavius Winslow, a 19th century evangelical preacher in England and America, who said, "Behold in faith the sinless, spotless Lamb of God, as having already borne that weight, as having suffered for those sins, as having died for those transgressions, and accept the precious truth that it was God's eternal love that laid them all on Jesus, and that nothing is left for you to do but to believe in Jesus, that he saves to the uttermost all that come unto God by him.
This evening's epistle to the Hebrews is chapter 4, verses 14 to 16. Since then, we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God. Let us hold fast to our confession, for we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but we have one who in every respect has been tested as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore approach the throne of grace with boldness, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need.
Amen. We will now be blessed with an anthem, with Bill on clarinet and Ken on trumpet. Ah, Holy Jesus, they shall play for us. As we continue on our journey through Lent together with our penitent hearts, as we continue to look yonder to Calvary, may the Holy Spirit lift our eyes again even further for us to see Jesus, who Jesus is for each one of us, and help us to deepen our relationship with him, enabling us to truly feel, to hear and feel and taste and see Christ crucified and what that redemptive work on the cross means for you and for me. And you're going to do one of our favorites.
Sure.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead precious Lord, linger near when my light is almost gone. Hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When the darkness appears and the night draws near and the day is past and gone, at the river I'll stand, guide my feet, hold my hand, take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. At the river I'll stand, guide my feet, hold my hand, take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home.
Let us all pray now the prayer by Ignatius of Loyola. O Christ Jesus, when all is darkness and we feel our weakness and helplessness, give us a sense of your presence, your love, and your strength. Help us to have perfect trust in your protecting love and strengthening power, so that nothing may frighten or worry us, for living close to you, we shall see your hand, your purpose, your will through all things. Amen. Our sending hymn for this evening is On Eagle's Wings. For those with the ELW that would like to sing along or follow along, it's number 787, On Eagle's Wings.
Thank you.
wish you a blessed evening. Go in peace. Join together in Christ with us.
Thanks be to God.